Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about what CORS is, its preflight request scenario, and the HTTP request and response headers. So let's get started. Cross-origin resource sharing is a header-based mechanism that specifies how web browsers and servers can interact and determine the safety of cross-origin HTTP requests and data transfers. Origin, in this case, includes both the port, hostname, and scheme associated with a request. CORS allows or disallows access to resources outside of a domain from which resources were initially provided, depending on the setup. CORS is a way of relaxing the same origin policy to enable controlled access to one website domain from another via HTTP requests. This controlled access is achieved via HTTP headers and the instructions contained therein. As part of the CORS response, a server can also inform a client if cookies or authentication data can be sent with a request. The CORS policy does not serve as protection against cross-origin attacks, and it may even enable them. A poor cross-origin resource sharing setup may make cross-site request forgery and cross-site scripting attacks easier, so it must be understood and implemented well. One of the protocol headers used in CORS is the access control allow origin header. This header is returned by servers when a cross-origin request is allowed, along with the conditions under which it is permitted. The CORS specification allows browsers to perform a preflight request to a server via the options method. This is used to determine whether they will be allowed to perform a specific cross-domain request, especially one that contains non-standard HTTP methods or headers that can modify data. The preflight request is a security measure to protect servers from the greater flexibility afforded under CORS. In this scenario, the browser sends headers to the server using the options method that specifies the methods and headers it intends to use in the actual request. The client request will be made if the server allows the methods and headers in the response. Under CORS, many additional headers are used in the cross-origin request and response to navigate the exchange. These include the HTTP client request headers, such as origin, access control request method and access control request headers, and the HTTP server response headers, such as access control allow origin, access control allow credentials, access control expose headers, access control max age, access control allow methods, and access control allow headers. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.